And now, as promised, I'm delighted to welcome into the studio Jack Lukeman. Yeah. Jack, it's very good to have you here this evening. And before we go any further, I want to introduce you a bit more to our audience. And for those that don't know you, I want to get them familiar with some of your great music. So let's hear something of yours to start with. What should we hear?
Oh, this one is called Magic Days and Magic Ways.
And where does this come from? Where do you?
Well, the last album I released was called Magic Days, so it's the title track from it, and it's a promise of a positive future.
Great. That's what we do. That's exactly what we're after. Thank you very much. Let's begin with that.
Crawled here on my hands and knees to pour it out just how I feel. I try to speak but I can't say a word. I know I'm growing old disgracefully. The spotlight's on, it's plain to see. You're like an angel glowing in the dark. So don't stop receiving the signals loud and clear. Just stop believing. There'll be magic days on magic ways. Magic days on magic ways. Magic days forevermore. Everybody knows your name, the good, the true, the beautiful, the vagabonds, the liars and the thieves. You know you got so many pairs of shoes, but still you don't go anywhere. Just sit around counting broken dreams. So don't stop receiving the signals loud and clear. Be magic days on magic ways. Magic days on magic ways. Magic days forevermore. So don't stop receiving the signals loud and clear. Just start believing. There'll be magic days on magic ways, magic days on magic ways, magic days forevermore.
The delightful sound of Magic Days and Magic Ways by our guest here this evening, Jack Lukeman. So, it's very good to have you here. Where does music begin for you? What was your first introduction to music you can remember?
Well, I remember the radio was always on in the house, so there was always music playing. But we did have sessions in the house when I was a kid. One of my earliest memories is waking up in the middle of the night to the sound of all the adults acting differently than they did during the daytime, having a good time. And
Were your parents musical?
Yes, my father has a marvellous singing voice, and everybody just loved music, you know. Records were a big thing, lots of records. Mm-hmm. My mother was into the Beatles, and my dad into the old crooners, so, you know, my mother was into Elvis. So I got all the greats from the very beginning, and it's a good place to start, you know, with all the
the Big Bang really is Elvis and Sinatra, really, isn't it?
And when did you realise it was something you could do yourself?
Well, I was lucky enough to be born with the gift of a voice. So when I would sing, when I was a kid, I had the voice, soprano voice. And then when my voice broke, I had a really low voice and everybody used to laugh when I sang. I was like, you know, I sounded like Paul Robeson when I was 14. But so, slowly, but you know, when we would have family get-togethers, we would all be made sing. Everybody would do their part piece and people would react. And I suppose from there... And I was just always obsessed with music, so I was in, you know, bands in school and...
What was your party piece?
Minnie the Moocher.
Oh, that's quite a party piece,
isn't it? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Stuff like Moon River, all those old classics.
Quite big, difficult things to sing for a young lad.
Yeah, I suppose, yeah. But I've, you know, having a voice and, you know, it was something I would entertain myself with. You know, so I suppose I, unbeknownst to myself, I was always rehearsing by singing. I wasn't particularly interested in school or anything. Music was always the passion and the obsession. So thankfully, I've been able to maintain it. So
let's talk about some of the things that influenced you. The first record you've chosen is by Scott Walker. Tell us about this.
Yeah, well, The Port of Amsterdam by Scott Walker is just, it's just one of those. Well, number one, it's Scott Walker, you know, it's... his fantastic voice put to the great song by Jacques Brel, and it's just a marvelous epic tune. You're there, you're in Amsterdam with all the sailors. One of my favorite songs, and also when I eventually started playing music for real, I was busking, and Holland was the place I was busking in, places like Amsterdam and that. So it reminds me of that. And I went on to record an album of Jacques Brel's songs. It was one of the earlier things I did. So this is just one of my favorite songs. It just it's I think if Orson Welles wrote and sang songs, they would sound like this kind of thing. You know what I mean?
It's a great 3D song. Let's hear it.
In the port of Amsterdam, there's a sailor who sings of the dreams that he brings from the wide open sea. In the port of Amsterdam, there's a sailor who sleeps while the riverbank weeps with the old willow tree. In the port of Amsterdam, there's a sailor who dies, full of beer, full of cries, in a drunken down fight. But in the port of Amsterdam, there's a sailor who's born on a muggy hot morn by the dawn's early light. In the port of Amsterdam, where the sailors all meet, there's a sailor who eats only fish heads and tails. He will show you his teeth that have rotted too soon, that can swallow the moon, that can haul up the sails. And he yells to the cook with his arms open wide, bring me more fish, set it down by my side. And he wants sort of belch, but he's too bold to try, so he gets up and laughs and he zips up his fly. In the port of Amsterdam, you can see sailors dance, marches bursting their pans, grinding women to punch. They've forgotten the tune that their whiskey voice croaks, splitting the night with the roar of their jokes. And they turn and they dance and they laugh and they lust till the rancid sounds of the accordion burst. Then out to the night with their pride in their pants and the slut that they tow underneath the street lamps. In the port of Amsterdam, there's a sailor who drinks, and he drinks and he drinks and he drinks once again. He drinks to the health of the whores of Amsterdam, who have promised their love to a thousand other men. They bargain their bodies and their virtues long gone for a few dirty coins. And when he can't go on, he plants his nose in the sky and he wipes it up above, and he pisses like a cry for an unfaithful love. In the port of Amsterdam,
what a fantastic, epic piece that was. I mean, we were thrust into the back streets of Amsterdam. Now, you said that that you would busked there.
Yes.
And how was that? How did you? What made you decide to go and busk in Amsterdam, of all the places?
Well, I was actually. Well, I went over there with some friends, and I was working in a. Tulip factories, of course you would in Holland, working on conveyor belts and all that kind of stuff. But then I started busking, and I was basically making more money busking, so that made more sense. And you know, it's that thing when you're a musician, going from having a normal job to actually being able to survive as a musician is one of the hardest things. So that was the quantum leap, I suppose, that made me go, oh, I can actually survive doing this, and on I went.
Much more fun playing than working with the tulips. Where yeah. in Amsterdam did you busk? I'm trying to visualise it.
The Leiserplein, is that what it's called? It's right. Leiserplatz. Yeah, I used to busk in Leiden a lot as well, which is another city as well.
Where Rembrandt comes from, isn't it?
Uh-huh. Yeah. So yeah, so it's good. It's good. I don't know what it's like now, but it was a. You know, there's so many laws against busking now, but back then it was a free for all, which is great.
So you've we've been playing your records, but also the records that have been inspiring you. And I should explain to some of the listeners that you've been on tour with us, and you've been touring sort of everywhere, really, haven't you? Doing lots of gigs, got your records out.
A great time touring around the UK. I did a massive tour with the Proclaimers, with Imelda May. You know, so I've Neil Sedaka. Graham Gouldman. So I've had a fantastic time seeing all the amazing venues and building. It's been great building up a fan base here.
The crowd, you always manage to get the crowd going. Do you think that's your busking training coming in?
Yeah, I think gigging is just an extension of busking. It's the same thing. It's trying to engage an audience, and obviously it helps. Busking helps project your voice, because at the time we weren't using any amplification. You know, it was the old Al Jolson, sing it as loud as you can kind of thing. So yeah, definitely. And I've got very warm reception. I mean, everybody's been very, very great audiences, music lovers, you know.
People that's all I want. Wherever you go, I mean, they do. It's a great performance. What's the next one you've chosen is by Nina Simone. Tell us about this.
Well, I suppose this, number one, it's Nina Simone once again singing a great song, a Randy Newman song. And I'm a big fan of Randy Newman. This kind of got me into Randy Newman. As much as beforehand, I would have been a massive Nina Simone fan. After I had read her biography, I put a spell on you, I think it's called. Fantastic read. Just a gifted woman who could just play since she was a kid, and a prodigy, and her story is fascinating. And and then Randy Newman, I actually recorded an album of Randy Newman songs too, and this song kind of led me into that, you know, into great songs like In Germany Before the War, all those great songs. And this particular one, it's just nice to hear a reggae beat with some strings, and just the way she approached it differently than the way he wrote it was also fascinating. It's just a lovely groove as well.
She's very good, I think, at introducing us to a song that we didn't know we liked.
Yeah.
You might have heard it a few times, and you hear her do it, and you go, wow, I really like that song now. She's kind of a great doorway into sort of songs you don't know.
Yeah, she's just got one of those voices you believe when she sings, you know, and which is the all essential.
Ways of arranging it. Let's hear that.
Little seagull on a marble stand, trying to find the ocean, looking everywhere. Hard times in the city, in a hard town. There ain't nothing here for free. Look on the corner, waiting for a train. Drunk, lying on the sidewalk, sleeping in the rain. they don't know why.
Nina Simone with Baltimore, chosen by our guest here this evening, Jack Lukeman. Jack's busy touring. He's busy. In fact, where are you doing lots of shows in the coming few months?
Yes, I've got a. I'm currently just trying to record a new album, but I'm back on the road in. Let me see, November, December, and back all around the UK.
The next song you've chosen is a very interesting subject. So Long, Marianne, by Leonard Cohen. And tell us about why you've chosen this one, because there's a film has just come up about this whole subject.
Yes, which I actually wasn't aware of when I chose the song, but it's just one of those. I mean, I listen to a lot of Leonard Cohen lately, because when I'm writing songs, I listen to a lot of Leonard Cohen, because you just see how great it can be writing lyrics, you know? I mean, he was a poet. So I just love this song. I just love the lyrics. We met when we were almost young, deep in the green lilac park. You held on to me like I was a crucifix as we went kneeling through the dark. I mean, it doesn't get much better.
The other thing you get is what an extraordinary poet he was, and the way that he looked at things. Also, he's very dry and very, very funny.
Yes.
But has like an amazing way with words.
Yes, yes. And marvellous with an audience also. I saw him in Dublin a few years back, and he was just amazing live. It was one of the best gigs I'd ever seen, which you would never think, you know, his songs seem so mellow.
It's great that you've chosen this as a song to do, because it is a great love story, is what it is. And having just seen the film, it means something to me. For those of you that haven't seen the film, I'd recommend it, but it is about this lifelong love affair, isn't it?
Yeah, fantastic song.
So let's give that a go, if we may.
Let's do it.
Come over to the window, my little darling. You know I'd love to read your palm. I used to think I was some kind of
gypsy boy. Before I let you take me home.
Jack Lugman, performing live with us here in the studio, So Long Marion by Leonard Cohen. That's a really lovely choice of song, that. Great.
Pleasure to play it with you guys.
And you were saying you like Randy Newman and very much did a Randy Newman record and like Leonard Cohen. They're people who are great poets.
Great wordsmiths, yeah. I mean, I've always been into lyrics and, descriptive kind of lyrics. And they are the greats, like Jacques Brel and, putting the magic into the mundane things and, brightening up the world.
I've got a copy of your record, Magic Days. You're working on another one at the moment.
I sure am, yeah.
And you're doing some shows. Where can we see you?
Yeah, the tour kicks off in December on the 3rd in Glasgow and runs them in Birmingham, Newcastle, Manchester, Hull, and there's two nights in St. Pancras Church in London on the 12th and 13th. So it'd be nice to tour around the old Christmas period.
And we're going to go out on something of yours now. What should we play of yours?
The King of Soho, which is an old foot stomper.
And what inspires this song?
Well, I always introduce it as it's an imagining of a guy who's tunneling his way out of prison and imagining that when he escapes, everybody will sing his old nickname, the King of Soho.
Is it based on anybody in particular?
No, it's kind of like a Mac the Knife kind of song, a bit of fun. And it's got that answer and call thing, which is a bit of Minnie the Moocher in there too. So it's kind of a combination of, I suppose, songs I've sang over the years.
Well, we'll look forward to hearing that now. Thank you for being our guest this evening.
Thank you for having me. Cheers. Thank you.
When I get to the river, past being.